Blogging. All right, so I'm making a little blog. It's kind of weird because this camera has a pop-up, so I don't know if I'm looking at the top or looking at a thing. I'm looking at a thing so that way it doesn't look like I'm looking above it. All right, so anyway, I'm gonna show you something real quick. It has to do with my workout. So flip the camera thingy around, go to this. This is a big spreadsheet. It's my sanity check sheet too. But anyway, if you look up, there's
a whole bunch of mumbly-jumbly about workouts, and their volume progression. So, for instance, this is today, day two, week two, lot two. And when you go to the gym, you do squat and bench as my strength exercises, and I'm either going to do 3 sets of 6 at 305 or 355, or 3 sets of 6 at 285 or 265, depending on how I'm feeling. And that kind of goes back to 2 different progression algorithms based off of performance on this as many reps as possible test that was done right here, or based off of progression on performance as it related to RPE on this previous final block. So it's kind of interesting transition there. If you want to know more about it, just ask me in the comments.
But anyway, we are about to go to the gym. And for stylistic purposes and editing and whatnot, I'm walking towards my car. Notice my little mask beard. This proves that it's 2020. All right. So, get ready to drive to the gym. All right, so the pre-workout has started to kick in. I'm gonna put on some of my favorite jams that I like to listen to on the way to the gym. What do we want to do? Oh, there we go.
The Peter Schiff Show.
All right.
Today's episode of the Peter Schiff Show podcast is...
All right, well, Peter Schiff is thanking his sponsors. I actually like this podcast. I know he's kind of like... He has a vested interest in selling gold because that's what his company does. He talks a lot about it, but it's good financial news. It's good, just general financial news talking about markets and stuff like that. Sometimes I listen to other stuff, some of the other stuff, like, let's say Sabaton. Sabaton's really good to get the blood pumping. And of course, when you're sorting through playlists and listening to all that, do it from a parked car. You don't want to do it while you're driving. Oh yeah. Feeling it. It's going to be a good workout. I couldn't find any tens. So we'd have lots of fives. All right, first set.
Let's do it. We're filming, Q. Which means I can't screw up, right?
Which means I can't upload you either.
3 sets of 6.
Come on, you can do it.
Up and slide. Come on.
I'll get like a tattoo?
Yeah, no, like.
I try not to even say that. I'm like, I am not affiliated.
And the pouch, you have an arrow pointing down, and the bag is actually the beer bottle.
You, game's on tap. All right, my wrist was acting up a little bit. So on any heavier sets, wrapping them up. Really good, albeit brief workout, feeling accomplished. And now I'm gonna go have tacos and some beer as a post-workout, hence the beer bod, my buddy Raymond. All right, food here in a little bit. All right, it's dinner time. So I had chips and queso, a couple sangrias and a fish taco. So we're gonna log this in the app. Check out this nifty little window where we can see what I'm doing in here. I'm gonna start logging my food. It is outside of my eating window. Hey, there's Raymond. It's outside of my eating window. And I'm gonna say that's all right. So I'm adding my fish taco. I go ahead and add that fish taco in. I can kind of see the effect that it had on the macros. I'm gonna log my sangria there in alcohol mode. See that little preview for what it's gonna do. So I'm adding my sangria. I later go back and update it to two sangrias because that's what I had. Also adding my chips and queso. So since I had chips and queso before, ooh, look at that sangria. That's good stuff. But because I had that recently, it'll show up there instantly in my recent items so I can quickly add it from there. And so now you can see that that put me in range for both my carbs and fats for the day, but I still have some protein left over. So what am I gonna do about that? What I'm gonna do is just have some whey protein. I'm gonna duplicate that because I had it at breakfast. And now I'm gonna drag and drop that duplicated protein over to my dinner. And I'm also gonna go ahead and edit it because 1.5 scoops will do the trick. It did put me a little bit over in carbs and fats, but really not a problem. I'll make it up another day.